is Melissa Carmen, and I am the director of the Sutliff Museum located in Warren, Ohio. In this series, we will be introducing you to the many members of the Sutliff family and sharing why they are important enough to have a museum dedicated in their honor. This first episode gets a little confusing with the genealogy. Believe me, I was confused, and I've been researching and sharing the Sutliff family history for almost 8 years. But as with any story, it's always better to start at the beginning. When the Connecticut Western Reserve became Trumbull County on July 10, 1800, and Warren was named the capital of this vast area, it was advertised in New England as a veritable Garden of Eden, a beautiful place for settlers to come and own land, to have freedom and space to enjoy a new life. Hundreds of people began to migrate to this new Trumbull County. Among them were members of the Sutliff family. So, who were the Sutliffs, and why should you care? The name Sutliff was derived from Southcliff, a place situated in Yorkshire, England, and was gradually changed until it was spelled Sutcliff. This, however, was not retained by the American branch, which we will be talking about. The omission of the C comes when the Puritans sought to break away from England, where they were ill-treated and persecuted, so they came to America. The American Sutliff line, as far as it can be traced, begins in the early 1500s under the rule of Henry VIII. Stay with me, as this is where it gets confusing. The Sutcliff family lived in West Yorkshire, England. Around 1550, the Sutcliff family becomes a very prominent and influential family with the birth of two brothers, Matthew and John Sutcliff. Matthew was educated and trained at Cambridge, then joined the clergy. On October 27, 1588, he became Dean of Exeter, a position he held for more than 40 years. He was appointed as a royal chaplain during the reign of Queen Elizabeth I and James I. Matthew was interested in the settlement of New England and was acquainted with many voyagers that traveled to the New World. Matthew's younger brother, John, became groom of the bedchamber to Charles I. Not much else is known about John, but we do know that he inherited most of Matthew's estate. It is presumed Matthew's interest in the settlement of New England and the aid of those who ventured there is the reason we see the Sutliff descendants in Massachusetts starting in 1661. The first Sutcliff we see in the Americas is Abraham. He immigrated from England to the New World with his family and settled on the coast of Scituate, Massachusetts. His son, Abraham, was 13 years old at the time of their arrival in Plymouth, Massachusetts. Abraham, the son, married and had three sons, who also migrated to help establish new settlements here in the New World. One of his sons, Nathaniel, settled in Dedham and then in Medfield, Massachusetts. Ultimately, Nathaniel would be killed on May 19, 1676 at the Battle of Turner's Falls, also known as the Peskiomskut Massacre in present-day Gill, Massachusetts. Nathaniel Jr. went to live at Rehoboth, Massachusetts following the death of his father. After marrying, he moved to Durham, Connecticut, where he became a man of property and great influence in that community. He was elected the first constable and also elected as a representative for four consecutive terms. Nathaniel Jr. died in April 1732, leaving nine children. One of those children, John, was early on connected with the train band or company of militia in Durham and attained the rank of sergeant. John's son, Samuel, moved from Durham to Hartland, Connecticut around 1783. We see a lot of the Sutliff men participating in the Revolutionary War. As a revolutionary soldier, Samuel Jr. received lands in Litchfield, Herkimer County, New York. In 1804, Samuel purchased 128 acres of land from the Connecticut Land Company at $3 per acre for a total of $384. He traveled with his wife Ruth and sons Alan Curtis and Samuel Harvey to Vernon Township, Trumbull County, Ohio. Following their settlement, Samuel and Ruth added four more sons to their family, Levi, Milton, Calvin Granger, and Flavel. Samuel Sutliff dies on February 7th, 1840, after being ill for an extended period. Ruth stayed in Vernon until she traveled to Iowa, where she lived with her son Alan Curtis until her death on August 7th, 1843. Thank you for joining me on this swift journey from 16th century England to 19th century Ohio. Next time we will look into the lives of the eldest Sutcliffe boys, Alan Curtis and Samuel Harvey, who left Ohio to venture further west to settle in Iowa. And why should you care? Join me next time to find out.